What's up, guys? Cipher Pol 808 back again. As you guys probably guessed from the title of the video, back for some more One Piece action. So today we got my live reaction to chapter 1033. But before we jump into the reaction, go ahead, do me a favor and hit the subscribe button if you guys aren't already subscribed to the channel, and hit the bell icon if you want to be notified of any future content. But now that you have, let's jump right into the video. All right, so starting off, chapter 1033, Shimotsuki Kozaburo. All right, so on the cover page, what do we got here? It says, Tashigi plays the villain for baby penguins that make believe as heroes. All right, so we got Tashigi over there. We got a bunch of little penguins on her. Okay, I'm liking it. We got Smoker kind of in the background, you know, sulking as always. Well, okay, that's pretty cool. Let's get into the chapter. All right, so starting right off, Zoro versus King. All right, we're jumping right back where we left off. All right, Zoro has to deal with a rogue sword. All right, so Enma was going crazy at the end of the last chapter, you know, starting to suck out his haki from his arm. Stop draining my energy. All right, so Zoro's he's already starting to get into it with the sword. He's like, without my permission, and he's getting mad at the sword. He's like, yo, I didn't give you permission to drain my haki. All right, and then, okay, now we're going over to King. He's kind of looking on, you know, his mask is still messed up, so we can see, you know, kind of his exposed hairline right there. Trouble in Paradise. All right, so he's noticing a little bit of discord with Zoro and his weapon right there. All right, so, okay, so King looks like he's rushing in for an attack right now. All right, do you guys think Zoro's going to be able to wield Enma, or is he going to, you know, take a couple of attacks before he's able to get it under control? All right, and then we see, okay, so he's like, huh? And, okay, wait. So he kind of just stops. King just like, you know, rushes in, and all of a sudden he just stops right before him, and he's just standing. You know, he's pretty massive. He's got his wings right there. He's got the flames behind him and everything. And Zoro's just like, what are you trying to pull right now? All right. And okay, so he goes in. Zoro lunges in for a stab and goes to stab him with the sword. And he says, ah, direct hit. Okay, so this is what he was alluding to last chapter. He's like, oh, it's not just because I'm a dinosaur zone that I can take damage. There's something else. So, you know, this has to do with, him from being that race that was atop the Red Lion, possibly. So maybe something about them, you know, they're very durable. All right, and then all of a sudden you just see this huge explosion. So he just, like, Zoro stabs him, and he's just, like, kind of mocks him. He looks down at him, and all of a sudden the next panel you just see this huge, massive explosion. Like, what the, I mean, I think it's got something to do with the flames, but, oh, man. All right, okay, now we're going back to Sanji. All right, let's see if Sanji's gotten his stuff under control. You know, I really don't believe that he hit that woman. Something's got to be up, but, you know, let's see what's going on with him. All right, so Skull Dome, Left Brain Tower, Pleasure Hall. All right, so someone's over there laughing and says, you just called Pirate Hunter, right? Okay, so this must be Queen. He's like, he doesn't stand a chance against King. All right, so Queen's kind of, you know, in the rubble right there. And we see Sanji kind of just looking on, smoking his cigarette. He's a surviving Lunarian. All right, so definitely it's got his durability has to do with being a Lunarian, whatever that, you know, entails. They were all supposed to be eradicated. Those monsters could have in any inhospitable environment the world threw at them. Those monsters could thrive in any inhospitable environment the world threw at them. All right, so maybe when they built Mary Joie, maybe they had to eradicate these guys because this is where they lived, you know, because everything up there, you know, the elevation, everything like that. Let's see. In the distant past, they were considered gods. Yep, and, you know, the celestial gods, you know, don't want anyone to be above them. So you can clearly see why they would be the prime subjects for eradication. How could beings like that get wiped out? That's something you have to find out for yourself. All right, so I'm not sure, you know, you guys think Queen knows and he's just not saying, or, you know, he's just kind of being a smartass and making it seem like he knows. All right. Okay, we're going back outside. All right, let's see how Zoro's doing. All right. Close one. I'd be a goner if I used armament haki a second later. All right, so he just kind of barely survived whatever that blast was. He got knocked back, but because he used haki, you know, he's doing all right. How's he still unscathed? He just blew himself up. One sword style. Okay, he's going back. He's trying to go in. Lethal Lion Song. Okay, so he slashes him again. All right, and he's just standing there. And we just see him. Okay, it just looks like he kind of split right down the center of his face. And Zoro's just kind of, you know, doing his little sigh thing. And all of a sudden, he kind of opens his eye back up like something caught his attention. And King's like right on top of him in a hybrid form, you know, pulling his head back again. He's going right back in for the attack, but Zoro's got, you know, his back exposed. Imperial. No way, that was one of my strongest. Okay, so Zoro's like, what the hell? This is one of my strongest techniques. Okay, Enma's going crazy again. It's starting to suck out his hockey. You know, his arm, he's just like, oh, like, come on, stop it, Enma. And then right as he's, like, you know, dealing with Enma, that's right when King releases his head. All right, and it looks like, okay, so it looks like Zoro was able to kind of just barely get out of the way. It looks like maybe it's grazing him right on the side. But damn, the impact from that attack just kind of blowing off. Not the side of the skull, but, you know, the side of the island that is floating with the skull dome right now. Oh, damn. It says a swordsman beaten by his own sword. That's a first. All right, so King's over there, you know, still talking trash to him. He's like, damn, you lost because of your own sword. Never seen that one before. And we just see Zoro. He's, like, just falling. And it looks like, okay, so it's the Sandai Kitetsu that's falling away from him. And he grabs it. All right, okay. What's going on right now? It says, you already wield Sandai Kitetsu. That is one of mine. What? Okay, so this is the flashback when he was talking to Hitetsu. It's cursed. I can't sell it, you moron. If you end up dead, okay, so this is, what's his name? Ippon Matsu Shop back in the East Blue. Your blood would be on my hands. I'll take it. All right, so Zoro thinking back to his sword, his, you know, tried and true cursed blade. All right, what do we got? He says, risking yourself to save a sword. All right, yeah, you know, there's a lot of history between Zoro and this sword, so, you know, he can't be just letting it fall down. You know, not into the ocean, you know, they're over landfall now, but he can't just be letting it fall away. That's his sword. Have you lost it? All right, so King's like, what are you doing? All this for just one sword? Are you an idiot? All right, and then we see, okay, so Zoro's fallen. And we see, okay, so King's in his Pteranodon form, and he's flying in. And it says, okay, it burns. What a relief. It didn't fall off the island. Wado Ichimonji. Okay, so he's Wado Ichimonji, okay, definitely can't be losing that sword. That's the sword he got from, you know, Kuina after her death. Sensei, please let me have her sword. Okay, it's yours. You know, to fulfill their promise to become the greatest swordsman in the world, he's got to have Wado Ichimonji with him. I'll get stronger. Okay, yep, going back to the flashback. I'll get stronger for the both of us. You know, with, what's your name? I'm going to be the world's greatest swordsman with Kuina. All right. Okay, now we're going back to the other flashback with Hitetsu. It must be fate. That white katana of yours is the Wado Ichimonji. It was forged by the same man that made Enma, the master swordsmith, Shimotsuki Kozuburo. I didn't have time to think about it before, but how did a sword from Wano wind up in the East Blue? All right, so we're going to find out how Zoro's master kind of ended up all the way over there. Imperial Twin Blades, all right. And we see King, he's just coming back in, you know, he's coming in for the attack again. So you've picked up your three swords. Alright, and now he's reaching back, he's grabbing Enma, we see him, he's just reaching for it. Alright, and King is just coming in for this attack right there. And then all of a sudden, okay, he just comes up and he's got, you know, both his all of his swords right there. And then, okay, what do we got right here? Okay, we're having a flashback with Momonosuke. It says, Zorojuro, I was told not to say snatchy. Okay, this is when, I think it was Kiku told him not to say it. And he says, it's just something I heard from an old geezer in my village. I've never used the word myself. And Mom was like, wait, what? You told me to say you've never used it. But, you know, he was talking about his master. And it says, that geezer always sat by the shore. I never bothered learning his name. All right. And he says, I only found out he was Kuina's grandfather after he croaked. Oh, okay, this is not talking about what's his name. This is someone else. The master swordsmith, Shimotsuki Kozuburo, left this country illegally over 50 years ago. Was that Kuina's grandfather? Was, you know, Shimotsuki Kozuburo, is that confirmation right there? I think so, yep, look at this. All right, we're going back. 13 years ago, the East Blue, Shimotsuki Village, Zoro's hometown. Okay, and we got the logo for the Shimotsuki Dojo right there. So this is where Zoro, you know, walks in and wants to try and train, and he ends up losing. Okay, and we see the kids. Looks like everyone's kind of training. Snatchy. It's a battle cry that gives you courage. Okay, so this is the old man that they're talking about that was sitting by, you know, looking off into the water. I don't think I'll use it. It sounds weird. Okay, so the young Zoro, he's like, I don't think I'll use it. It sounds weird. Say, old man, is it true you were a samurai? Everyone at the dojo says you were. All right, what do we got here? And it says Village Geezer. That's the, you know, when they introduce new characters, that's his name and title right there. Quiet boy. And he's sitting there fishing. He's like, you're going to bring the Marines down on my head. Why would the Navy care? All right, so Navy would care because Wano is a closed-off country, I'm guessing. None of your business. Now scram, you snot-nosed brat. All right, so he's like, yo, beat it, kid. Screw you, useless old windbag. All right, so Zoro's still a smart-ass back then. And then, okay, so we see Zoro, he's over there training and everything, and the, you know, old geezer, he's kind of just looking on, watching him. You fed up with practicing at the dojo? I lost to Kuina again. All right, so Kuina, you know, just whips his ass all the time. And so I guess he goes and talks to the old man after he loses. I need to train nonstop. What? But I don't have any money. It's fine. Take them. They're not much anyways. All right, so he gives him two swords. I can only make ones like these now. Use them for your training. Listen, swords exist to cut people down. When smiths create them, they ensure they can take as many lives as possible. All right, so alluding to this dude being, you know, a swordsmith, he's starting to, you know, kind of teach Zoro a little bit about sword lore and kind of the history behind them and making them. He's like, and he just kind of has this, like, concerned look on his face. All right, and we got a bunch of swords right here, you know, kind of in that, like, spinning. Okay, what's going on? We're going to give you a little history lesson. It says, each blade is like a person with a unique disposition. A swordsman is one who tames the sword's wild nature and bends it to their will. All right, so kind of like how Zoro threw up the sword and just, you know, stuck out his arm, you know, kind of putting out his force into the world. Like, I feel I have the confidence to wield this cursed blade. All right. It's a joke that deadly swords are believed to be cursed. That's just how name blades are. I consider it praise. Let the weak spread their nonsense. All right, so he's like, I don't believe in cursed blades. Like, that's just what blades, you know, a blade that did what it's intended to do. It means those swords fulfill their purpose well. All right, let's see. I crafted my magnum opus when I was still young. The temperament of that sword was something. All right, so I think he's alluding to Enma right now. You'd get the chills just holding it. I named that blade after the Lord of the Underworld. The Lord of the Underworld. Enma, and he's like, it's just now clicking in his head, like, in the middle of battle right now, he's remembering back to this, and it's clicking like, oh my god, that was the dude. He made Enma. He made this sword. And he's like, it's called Shimotsuki Village. That doesn't seem like a coincidence now. Okay. You know, Zoro, directions, you suck at it, but not realizing this sooner. Come on, bro. Did you know the village was founded by pirates? My grandpa told me. The master swordsmith Shimotsuki Kozoburo left this country illegally over 50 years ago. That geezer was a samurai of Wano. All right, so Zoro's just kind of laying there and thinking about this dude. He's like, that geezer was a samurai of Wano? He was the swordsmith, Shimotsuki Kozoburo. Oh, man. Name blades stay vigilant. They wait patiently to find a swordsman worthy of them. All right, so now did that old man realize who Zoro was, or, you know, who Zoro's lineage is? It is said a sword chooses its wielder. All right, Ippon Matsu, you know, telling him, it said a sword chooses wielder. That's what this is. It's testing me. All right, so Zoro's kind of realizing, like, this, okay, the sword chooses its wielder. You know, previously, Odin was the only one that could wield this sword. The sword chose Odin to allow it to wield it. Now that Odin's gone, it's testing Zoro to see if Zoro's worthy of wielding it. All right, so he grabs it again. The sword isn't acting out of malice. That means I've just not been measuring up to its standards. Okay, and then it says, you're telling me Odin was easily able to wield you, even while this much haki was pouring out of him? Is that it, Enma? All right, so is that just telling Zoro, like, bro, you need to step your game up. If you need to wield me, you better bring your A game. All right, look, it's the pirate hunter, King-san. Let's help him take his head. We're sure to get a promotion if we do, all right? So these dudes are trying to, you know, step in on this duel, and King was the one who called it a duel. What do I do? I can only appease it if I keep going all out with my haki, but that could kill me. All right, you know, we've already seen Zoro go, you know, pretty hard in this battle against Kaido. He was able to damage him. You know, he kind of showed that he's capable of Supreme King's haki. And he's still using, you know, currently in his battle with King right now, you know, he's been using a ton of armament haki. I'm sure some observation haki. So, you know, he's just had haki just nonstop this whole battle. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Is he going to be able to kind of summon, you know, kind of deep down from within inside him and just pull something out of his ass, some hockey reserve in him, and just go all out and just annihilate King coming up here? I hope so. All right. And then all of a sudden, no. This is how it's meant to be. And we see all the, like, the little fodder guys that thought they were going to take out Zoro and get a promotion. Looks like they're passing out. And King's like, I see. So you've also got kingly ambitions. All right, you know, he's destined to be, you know, king, top swordsman, king of the swordsmen. The world's greatest swordsman. That's perfect. The future king of the pirates wouldn't settle for anything less. And says, I guess you're right after all. I made promises to my captain and my oldest friend, Zoro. Yes. All right. So he made a promise to Luffy and he made a promise to Kuina. He's like, promise Kuina, I'm going to become the world's greatest swordsman. And he promised Luffy, he's like, I'll join you. And he's like, yeah, that sounds perfect. The world's greatest swordsman for the Pirate King. What more fitting? Like, yo, and Zoro is just realizing his potential right now. And he's like, yep, time to surpass his limits. Let's go. Oh, my God. I can't wait to see what we get next chapter. I hope they go straight back to this. I mean, I know there's a lot going on with Luffy and, you know, Kaido and Sanji and Queen. But damn, man, I want to see what Zoro can do with Enma now that he's kind of realized his potential and he's had this flashback and, you know, he realizes he met the man who made this sword and, you know, that revelation kind of helped him to gather and muster up the strength to kind of wield Enma right now. So I really want to see what's going to happen next, but damn, man, that was an excellent chapter. Let me know in the comments what you guys thought of the chapter, if you guys saw anything that I missed. If you guys enjoyed it, let me know. But other than that, have a wonderful day.